गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ शफ़ी फ्रॉम डॉन बॉस्को पीयू कॉलेज चित्रदुर्गा। वेलकम बैक टू द मैथ्स क्लास। इन अवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी लर्न द डेरिवेशन ऑफ द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू स्क्यू लेंस। इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू पैरेलल लेंस, राइट? यू जस्ट थिंक अबाउट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन पैरेलल लेंस एंड the skew lines, right? Now it is also the derivation important for 5 marks. Kindly mark it as an important one. Okay, it is the 4th derivation in your 3D. Now let us take 2 parallel lines. Derivation of distance between 2 parallel lines. Now let us take two parallel lines. It is the line L1. This derivation is also very similar to the previous one. It is a line L1 and it is a line L2. These two lines are the parallel lines. Now let the line L1 passing through the point A, along with its position vector is A1 vector. Let the line L1 passing through the point A along with its position vector is A1 vector. Next, second line L2. Let the line L2 passing through the point B, along with its position vector is A2 vector. Once again, let the line L1 passing through the point A along with its position vector is A1 vector. It is the line L2 passing through the point B along with its position vector is A2 vector, right? For these two parallel lines, 1 parallel vector will be there. For these lines, 1 parallel vector will be there. That will be B vector. Okay, now AB. Now BC is the distance between 2 parallel lines. Now join this AB, then we will get a triangle. Here BC is perpendicular to both L1 and L2 as well as B vector. Here it is the angle theta. Once again, I will explain this diagram. Kindly observe, L1 and L2 are the 2 parallel lines. Let the line L1 passing through the point A along with its position vector is A1 vector. Let the line L2 is passing through the point B along with its position vector is A2 vector. Next, for these lines, 1 parallel vector will be there. That vector will be B vector. It is the vector B. That is what? Parallel to both L1 and L2. Next, BC is the distance between 2 parallel lines. Here, theta is the angle between L1 and L2 as well as the vector B vector. It is the explanation of the diagram. Now write down the explanation. Let the parallel lines, be first line L1 second line L2. First line will be R vector equals to A1 vector plus lambda B vector. Next, second line R vector equals to A2 vector plus mu B vector, right? Now, I told you that let the line L1 passing through the point A along with its position vector is A1 vector. Let the line L1 passing through the point A along with its position vector is A1 vector. It is a line L1 passing through the point A along with its position vector is A1 vector. A1 vector is nothing but OA vector. It's a position vector. OA vector equals to A1 vector. Similarly, second line, line L2 passing through the point B along with its position vector is A2 vector. Similarly, let the line L2 passing through the point, which point? B. Passing through the point B along with its position vector is A2 vector. Let the line L2 passing through the point B along with its position vector is A2 vector. Position vector is what? OB vector. About position vector, I already told you in the vector algebra itself. OB vector equals to A2 vector. Right? Next, here we just observe the figure theta is the angle between AB vector and B vector. Theta is the angle between AB vector and B vector. Once again, here we have the triangle. Theta is the angle between AB vector, B vector, which is B vector is a parallel vector to the lines L1 and L2. Since theta is the angle between B vector and AB vector. Now, you just observe the figure from the triangle ABC. From the triangle ABC, sine theta equals to what? Opposite by hypotenuse, isn't it? BC divided by AB. It is from the triangle ABC. Sin theta is what? Opposite by hypotenuse. Sin theta equals to BC divided by AB. Next, you just recall the concept of vector algebra and also you just compare this derivation with the previous one. you came to know the difference between the distance between two parallel lines and also the distance between two skew lines. You just observe, in our previous derivation we have used cos theta, here we are using sin theta, right? In our previous derivation we have used cos theta, here we are using sin theta. Now sin theta, you just recall the concept of cross product. That is what? That concept is belongs to the vector algebra. In vector algebra we have the cross product. You just recall the concept of cross product. Now suppose you just recall that since theta is the angle between, theta is the angle between A vector and B vector, theta is the angle between A vector and B vector, then sin theta is what? Sin theta equals to, this thing we already learned in our vector algebra. Sin theta equals to what? Magnitude of A cross B divided by magnitude A magnitude B. It is the formula to find the angle between the two vectors, isn't it? This concept we are going to use here. If theta is the angle between A vector and B vector, then the cross product of A and B can be denoted by sin theta equals to magnitude of A cross B divided by magnitude A magnitude B. Similarly, this symbol represents similarly, theta is the angle between B vector and AB vector. Then theta is the angle between B vector and AB vector. Now what about sin theta? Sin theta equals to what? Here we have, since theta is the angle between B vector and AB vector, by using the concept of cross product, how you are going to define this theta in this derivation? Theta is the angle between B vector and AB vector, then sin theta equals to what? In place of A vector, we have B vector. In place of B vector, we have AB vector, right? Now, magnitude of B cross AB divided by magnitude of B vector, magnitude of AB vector, isn't it? Theta is the angle between B vector and AB vector, then sin theta equals to magnitude of B vector cross AB vector divided by magnitude B vector, magnitude AB vector. You just substitute this one in this. Now sin theta, we have B vector AB vector, that is magnitude of B vector cross AB vector divided by magnitude of B vector magnitude of AB vector equals to BC divided by AB. BC divided by AB, right? Now, next step, magnitude of B vector cross AB vector divided by magnitude of B vector. I already told you in the last class itself that magnitude of AB vector is also equals to AB. Magnitude of AB vector is also equals to AB. AB equals to BC divided by AB. Since magnitude of AB vector is also equals to AB. Now AB and AB will get cancelled. Next, how you are going to write AB vector in the form of position vector? Magnitude of B vector cross AB vector, how you are going to write? Divided by magnitude of B vector equals to BC. B vector cross AB vector we have. How you are going to write AB vector in the form of position vector? I already told you in the vector algebra that AB vector is also can be written as B minus A, I mean OB vector minus OA vector. OB vector minus OA vector. OB vector minus OA vector. divided by B vector, B vector equals to BC. Now, what about OB vector and OA vector? OB vector is A2 vector. Next, what about OA vector? OA vector is A1 vector. OA vector is A1 vector, OB vector is A2 vector. We just replace it. Finally, we will get the derivation. This also can be written as BC equals to magnitude of B vector cross OB vector is what? A2 vector minus A1 vector divided by magnitude of B vector. Once again, BC equals to magnitude of B vector cross OB vector is what? A2 minus A1 divided by magnitude of B. If you are going to confuse, you can write down this step, that OB vector minus OA vector equals to A2 vector minus A1 vector. Hence, it is the vector form, which is a vector form. Call this as equation number 1. Hence, it is the derivation of vector form. Next, we have to derive this derivation in Cartesian form, which is a vector form. Okay, which is a vector form. Now, let us derive this one in Cartesian form. Before that, you kindly note down this derivation in your notebook without making any kind of mistakes. Take a screenshot. Okay, now let us move on to the Cartesian form. Cartesian form is nothing but what? We have to eliminate the vector form. Here we have A2 minus A1 and one B vector is there, that is what? Parallel vector. A1 vector is nothing but, which is a line L1 passing through the point A along with its position vector is A1 vector. A2 vector is second line passing through the point B along with its position vector is A2 vector. Now we have to define this A1 vector and A2 vector and also B vector. B vector is a parallel vector. Now let us define A1 vector. Next, A2 vector. Next, B vector. That is a parallel vector. Now, A1 vector, which is a line passing through the point A, x1, y1, z1. Cartesian form is what? x1, y1, z1. Let us represent that one in a vector form. x1 I cap plus y1 j cap plus z1 k cap. Similarly, A2 vector, x2 I cap plus y2 j cap plus z2 k cap. Now, what about B vector, that is a parallel vector, A I cap plus B J cap plus C K cap. Okay. Now we have to substitute these vectors in this vector form. Finally, we will get the Cartesian form. Now from equation 1 we have. You just substitute these vectors in this equation. BC equals to, BC is nothing but the distance between two parallel lines L1 and L2. BC equals to magnitude of B vector. B vector what we have? A I cap plus B J cap plus C K cap. A I cap plus B J cap plus C K cap cross next A2 minus A1 magnitude of divided by magnitude of B vector. Now here A2 vector minus A1 vector is there. A2 minus A1, X2 minus X1 I, Y2 minus Y1 J, Z2 minus Z1 K. A2 vector minus A1 vector is nothing but X2 minus X1 I, Y2 minus Y1 J, Z2 minus Z1 K. X2 minus X1 I cap plus next Y2 minus Y1, Y2 minus Y1 J cap plus Z2 minus Z1, Z2 minus Z1 K cap. Okay, now BC equals to BC is nothing but the distance between two parallel lines. BC equals to how you are going to find the cross product of two vectors. Here we have the vector AI cap plus BJ cap plus CK cap. Similarly, we have the one more vector X2 minus X1 I cap plus Y2 minus Y1 J cap plus Z2 minus Z1 K cap. How you are going to find the cross product of two vectors? We are going to use the determinants. We are going to use the concept of determinants. I already told you that I cap, J cap, K cap. Next, I component is A, J component is B, K component is C. Right? Next, here I component is X2 minus X1, X2 minus X1, J component is Y2 minus Y1, Y2 minus Y1, K component is Z2 minus Z1, Z2 minus Z1, divided by magnitude of B vector. Magnitude of B vector, how to find the magnitude of B vector? Square root of I component square, that is A square, plus J component square, that is B square, plus K component C, that is C square, right? Hence it is the Cartesian form. Hence it is the Cartesian form. One more thing, this must be a positive one, so that you just apply the modulus symbol. Hence it is the Cartesian form of the distance between two parallel lines. Write down this Cartesian form in your notebook. It is the derivation of the distance between two parallel lines. So it is also the derivation important for 5 marks. Kindly do not neglect this one. You just practice 3 or 4 times at your home, you will be perfect. One thing you have to remember, that you have to well known about the vector algebra, then only you came to know the concept of 3 dimensional geometry. Kindly do not neglect this one. If you know the previous derivation, you find very easy to derive this one. Okay, dear students, it is the derivation of distance between two parallel lines. It is a class for today. In the next class, we will solve the problems based on this derivation. Thank you.